Mga magulang at mga kaibigan, narito upang maghatid ng kanyang talumpati ng pamaalam ang valedictorian ng klase ng mataas na paaralang Ateneo de Manila taong 2012, si Danilo Lorenzo S. Atanasio.
Father Jose Ramon T. Villarin, Father Raymond Benedict Q. Hizon, our administrators and teachers, members of the Board of Trustees, parents, friends, and my fellow graduates, a pleasant evening to all of you. I was asked to write this speech with the theme of pamamaalam or farewell in mind. Suffice to say, I wasn't particularly keen on the topic. After all, farewell or goodbye, in our context right now, means saying farewell to the years we spent here in our beloved high school, which we might fondly regard as our second home. Goodbye carries with it such a ringing finality that I hesitate to simply say it and enjoy my summer. Perhaps saying goodbye is hard for us to do, simply because we have latched ourselves onto the memories that we have made. Imagine yourself as a climber wearing a harness with no ropes attached to it. As you move through high school and acquire memories, you steadily knot ropes onto your harness as you ascend. These ropes are attached to those whom you share memories with. In a blink of an eye, however, you find yourself standing at a peak, feeling victorious because of your achievement. At the end of the journey, however, your guide suddenly tells you that you have to detach the ropes in order to leap off the peak. I think I would be terrified and, frankly, frozen in fear if that happened to me. The challenge for us, then, is to find some peace of mind in this farewell. I would like to believe that goodbye is not just detachment. It is the ultimate test of strength. As the philosopher Roger Trafontaine aptly states in his work, Death, the Test of Love and the Condition of Liberty, he says, "Death this time, far from being experienced as a final absence, shows rather that I reach the beloved person more intimately than I could know and above all express." But so far from considering his memory as a lifeless and silent relic, I am inspired by his spirit. I keep myself in his brilliance. I consult him in the depths of my heart. He does not die for me. Of course, I'm not talking about death. Rather, if we use this in the context of goodbye, we see that the real strength of our relationship with others depends not on how often we see or interact with a person. My first point is this: only when we say goodbye can we move on and grow. Over the past few years, we have settled ourselves comfortably around a particular group of peers within an environment that we have grown very accustomed to. Routines and traditions are kept, and often we fall into a lockstep. We become afraid of the unfamiliar, and we stagnate in our comfort. Goodbye means stepping out of our comfort zone and making room for new things. How can we ever hope to be open to new experiences and new graces when we're desperately holding on to what is familiar and certain? Saying goodbye, once again, is a test of strength, a test of our will to be more than what we are right now. Goodbye allows us to challenge ourselves when we courageously tread on an unfamiliar path. As my Filipino teacher, Mr. Ronan B. Kapinding, puts it, saying goodbye gives us an opportunity to hold our own and not be dependent on other people to take the first step and make great things happen. saying goodbye to high school shows that we are ready to think for ourselves, to make decisions for that we ourselves believe in. Goodbye means telling the other person, thank you for what you have taught me. I will move on now and use these lessons to do great things. Not necessarily big things, but good things. Then you will see how much I have grown as a person. When we have bravely taken our different paths and we have proven that we can hold our own, our goodbye to our friends and teachers are a measure of how well we have formed our relationship with them. It is a test of strength because we will be able to see whether everything is still as fresh as it was back then. We will be able to see whether every inside joke is still understood, whether we are still familiar with each other's peculiarities, and whether what we have learned from each other is still treasured. I dearly hope that we do go back, not only to relive memories, but more importantly, to strengthen old ties, new stories, and new experiences. At the moment of farewell, I hope we don't forget to give thanks to those who served as our guides and lifelines on the way to the peak. So I give thanks to my family simply for loving me and taking care of me. Thank you to my brothers in class, to whom I owe treats to Jollibee, Palangkas, and 1,000 other things for their goodness. Thank you to my friends in the Sangu HS and CSO for teaching me to love service. Thank you to my org mates, whom I hope to play with even after high school. And lastly, thank you to my teachers and my moderators, whom I regard as my friends and models in my stay here in the high school. Saying goodbye is not simply moving on. It is moving forward. It is simply up to us to trust ourselves when we say that we are ready to do so. I've had the happy occasion of having all of you in my life. Congratulations to our batch 2012. Goodbye, good luck, and see you soon. Thank you and good evening.